Hi everyone, it's Jen and Belle, and we are here to do a book review for you on a book that I got over the weekend. It's a book that involves 9/11, and here's the book. It's called Thunder Dog, and it's by Michael Hingson with Susie Florey. And the book is about a blind man and his seeing eye dog. That's her. Her name is Roselle. And their escape from the 78th floor of the World Trade Center on 9/11. Now, I'm sure that we all know the story of the World Trade Center, so there's no spoilers here. Two planes crashed into the World Trade Center on that day, and the author, see, Belle left already. I told you, she just hates my videos. I don't understand why. But anyway, so the author had to escape from the Twin Towers, and obviously he was a blind man, and all he had to rely on was his dog and some colleagues. And it's a really great story about overcoming disabilities, and especially on a day like 9/11, when there was nothing but trouble and horror and scariness, and I don't think there's enough words to describe 9/11. I really wanted to read this when I found out about it because I read everything about 9/11. I don't know why. I'm in New York. I experienced it the same as everyone else. I was not in the Twin Towers, and I was not in the city at the time, but you know, we all watch it on TV, and everybody pretty much here knows somebody that was there and lost somebody. And it was a really horrific day, and I think even 10 years later, we never forget it, New Yorkers. It's always going to be in the forefront of our minds. And I like reading the people's stories because it always reminds me how thankful you have to be of every single day, because you never know what's going to happen. You know, you can't let somebody go out the door and not tell them that you love them, or let a day go by and people don't know how you feel about them, because you don't know if you or them will be there tomorrow. So I like reading the stories. I don't know if everybody likes reading stories about 9/11. I think some people would like to forget about that day or really push it to the back of their mind and not think about it, but I don't think that's the right way to be. I think that if you forget about all those people that died on 9/11, and also about, you know, if you push that day behind and don't think about it, then you're also forgetting about them and forgetting about our soldiers that are there fighting because of 9/11. I mean, they're fighting for our freedom and for those almost 3,000 people that we lost on that day. And unfortunately, here in New York, a lot of our firefighters and rescue first responders are still dying because of 9/11, because of the horrible things that they inhaled that day. So let me get off my 9/11 rant. This book is basically about hope, and it's a happy story. And if you like stories about animals, or if you have a disability, or, you know, just like really reading stories about overcoming odds, this is the book for you. The only disappointing thing that I found in this book was that there were no other pictures. I really would have liked to see pictures of the author and the dog, or, you know, not necessarily like 9/11 pictures or anything like that, because it wasn't that kind of book, but maybe just a couple more pictures. There is the picture on the front, and then in the back cover on the sleeve, there's a picture of the author and the dog, but that's it. In the book, the author also talks about his childhood and how he grew up and overcame his obstacles of being blind, how his parents did not send him to a special school. They just wanted him to be like a normal kid. They actually even let him ride his bicycle around the neighborhood alone, which I thought was weird, but I guess it wasn't weird to him or to them. It's just how they felt. And he doesn't let it stand in his way, and that's really what the book is about. And then at the end of the book, there's also some parts of it written from his wife, who talks about her experience on 9/11 and how she felt while he was going through all of this. It's a really great feel-good story, so I would say go pick it up. You would enjoy it. I read it in one day. It's not that thick. I think there's only like 230 pages or something like that in there. And then there's also some resources for blindness and, you know, just getting some more information. So definitely go pick that up if you like it. And what I really like about the cover of this is the firefighter in the background there behind the dog, because although, you know, the author and the owner is not a firefighter, I think it really is a strong statement to say that this dog is a hero. And of course, everybody considers firemen, cops, EMTs to be heroes, and I really like how the fireman is behind the dog. And also, my husband's a fireman, so I like that too. So that's the story of that, and I think you should go pick it up. So, a couple of other things. I'm going to be doing another book haul either during the week or perhaps over the weekend, I'm not sure. I have some more books coming in, and my husband's birthday is this Friday, so I'm going to be a little busy getting that together. But I'm looking forward to doing another video. I really like doing these. I really like watching other people's, and I think it's really fun for the book community. So it's really fun for me too. So I'll be doing another one. What else? You can always follow me on Twitter. I'm at Tinkerbell Pugs, and I have the link in my page, but I'll put it hopefully at the bottom if I remember. If not, just look on my channel. It's there, or it's at Tinkerbell Pugs. And if you're on Goodreads, let's make friends on there so we can see what each other's reading and have fun that way too. So if you have any comments or anything you think I would like to read, if you read some books about 9/11 or just anything you think, leave me some information, send me an email, do what you gotta do, and I'll talk to you soon. Thanks for joining, and happy reading!